Hey, what's up, everybody? Gabe here from Gabe's Music Discography, bringing you another video. This is going to be all my November purchases. 15, I guess, maybe. 5 albums or something and 10 CDs. I'm not sure I didn't count. Got them sitting right here, so I'm not going to worry about it. So that'll be this November purchases. Then Monday will be the second half, it'll be 3 artists that I have left for my J's. I'll put those up in the title for Monday morning to start your week out. All right, so I'm just going to get into it, right? This is the November purchases. These are just in alphabetical order. I'm going to start with the CDs. First up is Actors. It Will Come to You. I wish I would have looked up a guy. If you go back a couple videos ago, I had a conversation with some other guy, just a couple comments, and I saw this on one of his videos. He did like a shoegaze video, and this was one of the bands that was in there, so I checked it out, and I liked it, went and bought it. It's good. The one thing I'll say about it, I'll probably get more of these guys of Actors. The thing about it, I'll just say, is that after like the, you know, 8th or 7th song, it kind of just all kind of blended together in a way, like you couldn't differentiate between the songs. But I've only listened to it once, so that might change if I listen to it again or a couple more times. But yeah, I like it. It's in that shoegaze genre that they have. So yeah, Actors. Like I said, I don't know anything about them. I just went off this guy's thing and saw it, and I liked it. So that's one. And then I got these two I've already talked about. Beatles. I mean, if you can find these cheap enough, then go ahead and buy them, but I wouldn't pay $30 for them. But like I said, yeah, if you find them cheap enough. And I talked about these in my couple videos ago. I gave some reviews. This one I also found out, too, that they went back in the studio and re-recorded stuff. Like Giles Martin and some other people. Like, they actually went into the school, or to the school studio, and redid this, and I was like, what? That's like insane. Like, they're, and who knows if they're lying about the amount of stuff they did. What if they did a bunch of stuff and they're just not telling people? But yeah, they went back in the studio and re-recorded, and to me, that's, I don't like that personally. I don't, they should have just left it what it was. If they can't extract using AI at the best quality, then that's just it. You can't go in there and re-record it and be like claiming it's the Beatles. That's not right to me. But enough said about these. They've been reviewed. I don't know. That's just something that you should know about this too. You know, it's just like they went in and redid some of this stuff, which I don't agree with. But like I said, most Beatles fans are going to get these regardless. You know, like I said, if you get them cheap enough, if you can find them cheap enough, I would go ahead and get them just because it does sound different, clearer. All right, that's enough about those two. But so yeah, I got these two. Then I finally got around to getting the Daft Punk 10th anniversary. It's got the additional CD with like 30 some minutes. There's nothing special about the second disc. It's kind of, I mean, it's cool having this extra stuff that they couldn't put a song to, I guess. They, you know, they had these ideas and they just didn't work out. So, I mean, other than that, it's Daft Punk, Random Access Memories. You know, if you don't own this, if you can find it cheap enough with the bonus disc, go ahead and go for it. Otherwise, I don't know that there's any point to the bonus disc if you aren't a Daft Punk fan, but whatever. You know, it's not bad. I probably won't listen to it for like another year. Maybe something like that when I remember that I have the 10th anniversary. But whatever, that's Daft Punk, Random Access Memories, 10th anniversary. It's probably 11th anniversary now. That's how long it took me to buy it. And then this one I just listened to today, actually. This one has been up for a while. It's a Ziggy Stardust, The Spiders from Mars, The Motion soundtrack. This is the 50th anniversary. With like, I think it's got like 2 additional songs maybe that have Jeff Beck, like I think Round and Round and something, the medley, like with Gene Genie and some other stuff. Yeah, so this is the night that David Bowie killed Ziggy Stardust and didn't tell the band and stuff. And I was thinking about it. If he would have told the band, I bet this would have been a way better concert. Like, everybody just would have been, like, if they knew, it would have been just a balls out concert, I bet. You know, this was to the band, this was just like another concert, you know. But if they would have known that he was killing off, you know, maybe they hated Ziggy Stardust or something. I don't know. But not even that. It's just knowing that this was the last show that he was going to be performing. Man, if they would have known that, I bet this concert would have been one of the best concerts ever. But other than that, you know, it's just a Bowie concert. So it's good. I liked it. A lot of good stuff. But yeah, this is the 50th anniversary. Then I got this. I had some songs on my phone already. So I was like, oh, you know what? I'm going to go and because all the Beatles crap, you know, everybody's talking about the Beatles. So I got this, and everything I had on my phone was already stuff I wanted on this. I don't know. There's a lot of stuff on here. I mean, there's probably like 30 tracks on here. So there's some good stuff on here, but like I said, I already had everything that I wanted. I didn't realize it. I listened to everything. I was like, eh, I don't need it. Don't need it. So I don't know. John Lennon is the definitive Lennon, working class hero. You know, there'd probably be another essential. I think there's already one. Isn't it Imagine, like a greatest hits or something? This is two discs, so this is probably a lot more. Yeah, there's a lot of good stuff on here, but then there's stuff I don't care about. But that's that. Then I talked about this. Did I talk about the album? I don't know if I did. But I finally got this on CD, the Juan McLean, In a Dream. I can't show you the, I can if I do this. There's the, yeah, this is Nancy Wong from LCD Sound System. This is good. I talked about the other one, I think. Yeah, because I didn't have this yet. When I did my JCDs, sorry, I'm brain farting. When I talked about my JCDs, I didn't have this yet. But yeah, this one I prefer. If you are into LCD or DFA label, you know, check this one out. If you're going to check out anything from Juan McLean, check out this one. And then this one, I just listened to yesterday. It's the only thing I have from them, The Kinks. Why is that? No. Sorry, this is The Kinks double disc. The Power, what is it? The Power. It's got one of those long titles, one of those 70s pot smoking hippie. The Kinks, Lola versus Power Man in the Money Ground Part 1. This is the only Kinks I've heard stuff from The Kinks, you know, but I think this is their seventh album, maybe sixth album from, I think it's from 1970. This is like the two disc alternate. There's a lot of good stuff on here. I never listened to it before. I never heard it. It's like in a cardboard CD case and stuff. And it's got like the pictures and then the two discs. Yeah, I liked it. I'm going to go and see about more Kinks around this era. But yeah, I mean, it's got Lola, which everybody's probably heard, which I don't need to hear again. The 8-Man, don't need to hear that again. Rats, that was a really good song. I like that one. Yeah, Kinks. Lola versus Power Man and the Money Ground. So, my first Kinks experience, like for the full CD. Like I said, I'm going to go and check out some more Kinks around this era and see what happens, right? Okay, that's Kinks. This one, favorite top five album for me, Miles Davis, Bitches Brew. This is a Japanese pressing double disc SA CD. I paid like $27 for it, which I thought was kind of a steal, but love this album. Miles Davis, Bitches Brew. It's really out there. It's jamming. The thing that sucks about it is that when you listen to the album is that it was spliced together. So it's not one, you know, they say, you know, we'll just say there's a 17 minute song. And it's not them playing straight 17. It's spliced from different stuff. But if you listen closely and you got headphones on, you can hear when the tape changes, like when they cut the tape and put the, if you listen really closely, I'm not sure what songs, but imagine, you know, just listen to some of the long songs and you can hear it if you've got headphones on, and yeah, you can hear when they splice it. But other than that, man, I love Bitches. Like I said, top five album for me. I love this, way out there. And you know, in today's eyes, it's not way out there, but when he released it compared to his other stuff, it was way the, I was almost gonna say way the fuck, way the f out there. But yeah, I love this, man. It's so good. Love Bitches Brew. I have like multiple copies. This is one of the albums that I have a lot of copies of. Finally got around to listen to these old farts. Rolling Stones, Hackney Diamonds, SHM, Japanese pressing. I don't know. I'm sure it's been reviewed to death. I'll probably listen to it again, maybe within a year. Like I bought, was it Steel Wheels? I think maybe. And that one was just not good. It was one of those Steel Wheels in that era. It wasn't Bigger. I think Bigger Bang I liked better than Steel Wheels. I didn't like Steel Wheels at all. But yeah, this is, I mean, these guys are like 79, 80 years old. You know, you got to give credit to them for still being able to do this. So, you know, that's what it is, I guess, right? I mean, they're going on tour. I don't know, man. You know, whatever. It is what it is. It's 80-year-old, 79, 78-year-old dudes still rocking out. It is what, it's exactly what you would think. I mean, if people are thinking this is going to be Let It Bleed, you know, or any of that stuff. Come on now, right? Rolling Stones, Hackney Diamonds. And the last CD is, I didn't even know this came out. I was looking through their discography. I was like, what? When the hell did that come out? This is Swans, Leaving Meaning. Like I said, I didn't even know that this had come out. Double disc. It's like the typical Swans cardboard. It's exactly the same as like every... Well, that's starting to come out. They're starting to be like this now. Yeah, this is 2019. This came out. Like I said, I didn't even know this had come out. You know, you got to be in a real mood because this one's kind of mellow. There's not a lot of percussion on it. So I was kind of... It's like the first... I think it's maybe like the second song. Or I think it's like the third song. Whatever song it is. You know, it kind of... leads you into this false sense that it's going to be this rocking, you know, Swans album, but it's really mellow, long songs. Like this, I noticed too, or I saw, if you buy the album version, like there's about six songs that are 30 seconds cut off the album compared to this. So this is like the full version. You get the full stuff. Or if you bought the album, you're missing a bunch of the stuff. You're missing probably... between 4 to 5 minutes total of music. So if you're gonna buy this, buy the CD, because you'll get the full extra, not even extra, you'll get the full album. But yeah, like I said, this is pretty mellow. If you're looking for like anything like To Be Kind or Seer, or was it The Glimmer Man or whatever that one is, can't think of it off the top of my head. Yeah, it's a little sad by how mellow it is, but you know, if you're in the mood for that type of music, that kind of music, then go ahead and put this on or buy it. Okay, and now we're going on to albums. This album, well, alphabetical order. I probably don't want to start with W, right? I want to start with A. All Them Witches. I totally am always forgetting. Lightning at the Door. This is, I think there's... different versions. This is just the black vinyl. This is, I think, a 2013 release, but this is, I think, maybe a later reissue. I think it's a 2013 release. Could have swore that's what I saw. I mean, I don't have my reader, so you can't trust me. I don't have my old fart glasses. But I think that's what it was. I was like, you know, it's like maybe their second album. So I was a little leery of, like, is it going to sound... how's it going to sound? Is it going to sound different than their stuff? But man, it's just as good as all their stuff that they put out. I love this. I only listened to it once, but man, I'm going to listen to this album a lot. All Them Witches, Lightning at the Door. Yeah, if you like All Them Witches and maybe haven't heard this, I guess, because I can't get attached to their first album, but if you like their later stuff, you'll like Lightning at the Door by All Them Witches. These two I got, these were at, I think, Acoustic Sounds or Music Direct, one of the two. They were 50% off, plus there was a code for like 15%, so these were 65% off. Liars, this one is They Were Wrong, So We Drowned, limited edition, press on color, recycled vinyl. So when I bought it, I didn't realize it was recycled vinyl. Supposedly, this is the first thing I've had knowingly bought. Like I said, I didn't even know it was recycled. But there it says it. So this is recycled vinyl. And you know, surprisingly, it didn't sound that bad. I was expecting the noise floor to just be like overwhelming. But to me, it sounded fine. Yeah. My favorite is, I'm not going to tell you my favorite because I have their CDs to go over. This isn't my favorite. I do like this one. This is my second favorite. Good stuff. Like, if you've not heard Liars, they came out in the 2000-ish era, 2001, 2002, kind of around. They were in that New York scene with Yeah and LCD and Interpol and The Rapture. That's another one. Yeah, they came out. Yeah, if you've not heard them, check out this and something in Drums. I can't think of it off the top of my head. Yeah, it's colored vinyl, recycled. And then I got this one, same thing. It was 50% off plus 15% off coupon code. This is just self-titled. Oh, no. Well, it says they were wrong, so we drowned, but it's not that. This is, like, I think self-titled. Yeah, so this one I didn't like as much as They Were Wrong, So We Drowned. Yeah. If you're going to get one, I would maybe skip. But it's obviously your own personal opinion. But I'd never heard this one before. But like I said, it was 65% off, so I got it. And I wasn't blown away by it or anything. So that one's, you know, maybe it'll be end up on the secondary market. This one I haven't listened to yet, but I've heard it. This is that one that just came out, the 3LP. Like I said, I've heard it, but not this. I would assume it's going to sound... I'll have to open it, and I'll have to... In my December, maybe I'll review this with other... I'm not just going to do one video about this. I don't... But... And see, I'm assuming... So this is 1990. 89-90. So I'm assuming it's going to be like crystal clear, kind of clean sounding Grateful Dead. That's what I'm assuming I'm getting out of this. Like I said, I haven't opened it yet, but we'll see if I'm right. So in December when I maybe, or sometime when I do another video, I'll talk about this and see if I'm right about this crystal clear 89-90 Grateful Dead. And see, just even how the album sounds, the album might not sound that good. You know, it might be warped. Might have a scratch in it. I might have to return it, actually. So don't quote me on listening to it, because I got to look at the album first, the albums, and see if they're able to listen to. All right, now this next one. Wow, this album blew me away. And this is an album that's 40 years after their last release. It took the band 40 years to make this. Which, Zango. Yeah, like I said, man, I was blown away by this. They're from Zambia. Like I said, this is 40 years after their last release. And it's like, I don't know, I didn't listen to their album that they released 40 years ago, but I would assume it sounds like this. This might be a little more hip-hop-ish. There might be a little bit more of that in there, but it's like, it's Africa, you know, Zambia, so it's got that in there. It's got the hip-hop. It's got rock. It's kind of lo-fi. You would think that this is from, like, the 80s or 70s or something, just with the kind of lo-fi sound that it has. But, yeah, it's... I think it has like maybe one original member, like the main guy. I can't remember what it was said when I looked at. Yeah, I think you should check this out because it's almost like a, like every song is just like a little different. I think you should check if you're into. I don't know how to describe it, man. You know, like I said, it's got some African beats in there. They sing in Zambian. Is that the pronunciation of their language that they speak? Zambian is English. I think you're gonna maybe be blown away. Yeah, it's on yellow vinyl. Even if, you know, you don't, there's the hype. You know, you can just stream it on whatever streaming device you use and just listen to it. And I think you're going to be blown away. Because like I said, there's so many, this is something you could put on maybe like at a party. And it's going to please everybody because it's just so much going on. So it's so different every song. I mean, they all still, you know, it's not like every song is a different artist and every song sounds different, but they all have the same. I heard this term today. Somebody was talking about on a podcast, like the bed is still the same, but there's so much different variety going on also. Like, okay, the bed is the same, but the sheets change and the pillows. You know, how about that? That's what you can say about this. Yeah, Witch, Zango. I think stream it. See what you think of this. I think this album is... This might be one of the top releases for me of this year. I'm going to do a video of my favorite releases, you know, like everybody else does, and expect to see this on there. Witch, Zango. Oh, and by the way, oh yeah, Witch. I looked at what they ever was reading about just because I heard stuff about it and then I wanted to read a little bit. But Witch stands for. We intend to cause havoc. That's what it stands for. We intend to cause havoc. I could read my old handwriting. You know, that happens a lot with people, right? Yeah, so that's that. Those are my CDs that I bought in November, my albums I bought in November. I'll maybe listen to that Grateful Dead and get back to you on that one. And then Monday I'll have the Jade, three artists. I'll have that uploaded bright and early for you. And then a week or whatever, Thursday, will be more albums. We'll be hitting the 100 mark. All right, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time I do a video.